Gone back to the paper after the war, I suppose I'd be a well man by now.
Ow!
Take it easy, will you?
You go right back with Mabel and the boy. I'll tell you when I'm through with this.
Oh, say, for a sweet-looking somebody, you can cause more. Go away, will you, and take it easy. Let me alone.
Holding hands with pretty nurses.
Do you have to do that? Will you go away and leave me alone? What a pal.
Come on, roll over.
Say, can't you heat that stuff?
No, and the masseuse is busy, and I'm afraid we have no cream puffs for lunch.
James Lewis McFarland, sir.
Now, how about McFarland? How long has he been here?
About 3 years, sir.
A hopeless case, I guess.
Scar tissue on lung. Mustard gas. Very stubborn. Won't respond to treatment. I'd say he'd have about 6 months. Perhaps a year.
Now, we need his place for a man who may come in here and make a recovery. If he had McFarland's chance. Send him to Camp Kearney.
You didn't want me to hear that, did you?
Look here. You'll crack that other lung if you don't watch your step. I'll lie back there. Before I... You're about as sick as a horse.
So it's Kearney and a handful of clouds, eh? Look. What would you do if you only had 6 months to live?
Me? Mm-hmm. Well, first I'd go and see all my relatives.
I haven't any.
And then I'd pick out my own plot with a beautiful headstone. You know, with doves and a lovely, tear-lined stone.
Beautiful thought.
And then I'd get plastered. And I mean good and tight. And I'd stay that way. And I'd round up a flock of good time Charlie. And I'd raise so much cane getting into scrape, they'd have to pick me up with a bother.
Well, I'll be a son of a gun. Say, look at here. Look at how long has this been bottled up in you?
Oh, my goodness. I guess I didn't mean that.
Well, maybe not. But it's a swell idea. I'm going to round up my gang of good time Charlies and go on a buster that'll make all newspaper men green with envy. Gangway for a man in a hurry. Scram, you can't be in a list and keep your job. Yeah, go on.
But you're confined to quarters. Don't do anything rash.
Oh, no, I won't. Don't worry. Go on. We'll beat it, beat it.
Well, drink one for me and make it a big one.
Okay, pal.
Good luck, soldier.
Hey, where'd you get that outfit? Gonna fight the war over again?
Pipe down, I found it downstairs in the trunk.
Oh, boy, did I clean up on Handsome. And with his own dice, too. $2, baseball tickets, his pipe, and Fifi's garter. After 3 years, it comes back to Papa. And was he burned up?
Thanks. That's the $2 you owe me.
Where are you going? To pieces.
Thanks. I just about decided that my technique must be failing.
They must have thought you were selling something. That seems to be the only reason anyone wears an overseas cap these days.
Huh? Oh, yes, the cap. Well, even old soldiers have to eat.
How long ago did you leave that hospital back there?
Hospital?
Uh-huh. There's a distinct odor of a hospital about you.
You're right, lady. Anyone ever tell you about your eyes? Oh, but they must have. They're blue, aren't they? Your eyes, I mean.
Did you say something about your technique failing, Mr.
McFarlane. James Lewis McFarlane. Ex-newspaper man. More recently, Rehabilitation Hospital number 59, as you guessed. 3 white and 36. But just Jim to you, miss. Miss.
You going to the city?
Chicago.
But isn't that about 2,000 miles away?
Lady, I'm on my way for one wild, hilarious, 100% bust. What did you say your name was?
I didn't say.
That's right, you didn't. Hungry?
Rather.
Let me see. $3.60. 10 more miles and we eat. Say, listen, I used to know the smallest little joint down the road down here where you got everything from soup to nuts for the colossal sum of 40 cents. What do you say? After all, I got...
Sorry. Your way sticks to the highway. Mine turns off here.
Oh.
Goodbye. Good luck.
Hey, wait a minute.
Well, do you or don't you, soldier? Hmm? Oh. Hey, listen, if you're coming with me, come on, I've got to...
Say, mister, where does that road lead to?
To Peaceful Bay, down by the ocean.
Peaceful Bay. Pieces.
Say, are you coming with me?
Gee, she had pretty eyes. Don't sound like a very good detour, but I think I'll take it.
How long has Mrs. Cameron been away?
I don't know, but Mr. Hicks at the grocery said she'd be back tonight or tomorrow.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Hey, come here. Come up here. You know that I could bite you and make newspaper history, don't you?
Can you help me into the house?
Yeah, sure.
My heart. I guess I've been overdoing it.
Don't you worry, old timer. We'll get you inside. Okay?
Yes, I'm all.
Had a little trouble myself. Where's the aromatic spirits of ammonia?
In the kitchen.
I'll get it. I got it. Had enough of this darn stuff to smell it a mile off. Here you are.
Thank you.
Easy now.
Cuba. 98.
Yeah, I know. Argon, 18. Say, you're in a bad way. Who's your doctor?
Dr. Grayson. But you don't get that old sawbones around here. You don't want to send
me.
I
know. Listen, old timer. Doctors are a pain in the neck to me, too, see? Where's the phone?
Over on my desk.
Oh. Hello, say, give me Dr. Grayson. I don't know what his phone number is. Gotta hurry.
Serious this time, Michael. We've got to get you to a hospital and quickly.
Oh, you're crazy. What did I tell you? This old buzzard been trying to railroad me to one of those things for the last 10 years.
But, Michael, I...
But my bees, who's going to take care of them for me?
Well, how about your neighbor, Mrs. Cameron?
Margaret? Margaret's all right to cook and to take care of a poor old fool like me. Too good, but my bees and my garden, they're a man's job. Besides, Margaret's going to the city for a few days. Hospitals, beds, invalids. Oh.
Say, listen, hospitals aren't as bad as you think they are. No, honest, they're great. I ought to know. I've been in dozens of them from one end of the country to the other. The doc here is right. Sure he is. You've got to give yourself a break. You know, take it easy for a while in a hospital where they know what it's all about.
But my bees, my God, they're living, breathing things. They're people. My friends. They can't be neglected for even a few days.
Well, a few days is better than well, you know, maybe for good. Come on, soldier. Give them a break, too. You know, fix it up so you can come back in good shape.
Could you? Would you mind, son, staying here for a few days and kind of taking care of things for me?
Me? Gee, gosh, I don't know any more about bees than I do about buzzards. The kind in the wing, I mean.
Well, my old partner will turn up to help you. And Margaret Cameron, she'll come over here to take care of you. You see, you're a friend. There's everything here that you need. Move in. Make yourself at home.
116K.
You know, as one soldier to another.
Dr. Grayson speaking. Send an ambulance out to the B-master. You know where it is.
Will you stay? Will you?
Yeah, sure. I'll stick around for a couple of days till your partner shows up. Had a long trip ahead of me, and well, I made one little detour. A couple of days more or less won't spoil my parade.
Oh, fine. Fine.
And the leaf-cutter bees, or megachile, which differ from Andrena and Halictus, and agree with Osmia, Apis and Bombus, in having elongate tongues. Well, I'm glad somebody agrees with them. Sladen states, Sladen must be another bee-nut, that the queen, belonging to the virginal form of Bombus terrestris, often invades a nest belonging to the lucrum form, kills the rightful queen, nice company we're keeping, takes over the nest, drives out all the... Oh, applesauce. And I'm the lad who is going to have one last fling. Look at me. Oh, baby. If you could only cook. I'm as hungry as a horse.
Better in English as we can read.
Well, what do you know? A radio.
What'll it be? Amos and Andy or a Bing Crosby?
Now, my dear little kiddies, the first thing you must learn is there are 4,500 different kinds of bees. And, furthermore,
I don't blame you.
Kind of a pal, you'd hightail it out of here and round up that fellow that helps the bee master. Well, if I got to do it, I gotta do it. Taking no chances, though. My boy, I'm merely trying to convince the bees of my peaceful intentions.
Well, how did you get here in the bee master's garden?
Well, son, it's a long story. I won't bother you with the details. The old bee master asked me to stick around for a few days and kind of keep my eye on things until his old partner showed up to take the job off my hands. Maybe you can give me a line on the old fella.
Sure, only he's not so old. He's scoutmaster, general of the peaceful bay troopers, chief of the robbers' den, and the bee master's first assistant. Because there isn't anything the bee master knows about the bees that he hasn't taught him. In other words, him is me.
What the... Oh, so it's a man's job, huh? You're a child, a baby.
I'm not a baby. I'm 10. The bee master calls me little scout.
Oh.
What are you groaning about? Don't you know that this is the keenest place in the whole wide world?
Oh, yes. Yes, sir.
I bet it's just about cracked the bee master to pieces when they took him away. Mr. Hicks down the take it. The bee master says you can stay and tend his bees in his garden. You've got to come clean on everything. The bee master never held out on me.
And neither will I, son. He was the sickest man I ever saw, and the gamest one, too. And fella, I've seen a lot of them. Oh, no. Come on.
He's not gonna die.
No, no, of course not. Especially not if we give him something to not worry about, you know. Look, I tell you what. You could quite a job on your hands around here, but you don't know it, showing me the ropes all around here. I'm just a greenhorn.
Well, son, good enough for the bee master. You're okay for me. Put her there, partner.
There.
Oh. Oh. Say, what's your name?
Oh, James. Jim McFarland.
Jamie. First thing you ought to know that there are 4,500 different kind of bees. Come on, I'll show them to you.
I was afraid of that.
Come on. Don't be afraid. Those guys will hurt you.
I'm not so sure.
Come on. They won't hurt you if you don't pay any attention to them.
Yeah, I heard the same thing once about a mad dog.
Don't hit them. You'll make them sore, and then they will get mad.
Say, look, couldn't we postpone this until tomorrow?
Where's your skunk? You're going to make me smoke them down like a sissy, huh?
Well, no. Go ahead. Hey, what are you doing? Drop that thing. Put it down.
I want to show you three kinds of bees. Here, hold out your hand.
Oh, no, you don't. Not me.
It's a drone, silly. And drones don't have any stingers. There.
Gee, he's a whopper, isn't he?
Uh-huh. About twice, almost three times big as a worker. They're the gentleman bees. I call them Romeos. Just like the bee master said, their only duty is to make love to the queen so she can lay eggs.
Oh, I see.
They are in the drones. They're the workers.
Busy little devils, aren't they? How many do you suppose there are in one of these hives?
Oh, 50 to 60,000. Sometimes more.
In one of these things?
Uh-huh. See, about half of them are the old bees. They know more, so they do the outside work. Fielders, we call them. They gather the honey and water for the family and make the bee glue.
Bee glue? What do they do with that? Glue the honey in the hive?
No. Gee, you've got a lot to learn. They use it to plaster the inside of the hive, like to do a house, to make it water and airtight. That's part of the job of the youngsters, when the older ones bring it in.
What else do the youngsters do?
Oh, gobs of things. Only the most important is feeding the eggs and taking care of the queen. They bring her a fancy food and they make a fuss over her.
I'd kind of like to see her, Royal Highness. I suppose she's sitting in there on her throne.
I suppose you just sit. You had to lay between 2,000 and 3,000 eggs a day. Yeah. See that big long one? Mm-hmm. That's the queen.
Streamlines and everything, huh? What's the reason for the polka dot?
That's her makeup.
Oh, just like a girl.
Uh-huh. Only not all of them have decorations. Just once in a while.
What's she doing now?
Laying eggs. Sometimes after she's laid, 1,000 eggs in one frame, the nursing bees come along and seal it up with the bee wax holding a hat. There, see that patch of them there all sealed up?
What makes it all drippy and gooey?
It's green honey, unripened. The job of the workers to keep the heat of the hive so it'll evaporate the moisture out of the nectar.
Boy, these are interesting, aren't they, huh?
Mm-hmm. Sure are. Well, you get studying about all their personal things and the thousands of smellers. And
do you get the honey out of one of these things? You know, and put it in bottles so you can sell it for waffles and hotcakes.
That's a fish. You see that house over there?
Uh-huh.
That's the honey house. Come on, I'll show you how it's done. Take this steam knife. It's got to be awful hot. Wet, clean and fast. Like that.
Slick as a whistle, huh?
Yeah.
What's this?
An extractor machine. Whirls the honey out of the flame. Now look down there while I turn it.
Boy, sure does the trick, huh?
You betcha. As the bee master said, this is a little outfit compared with the big ones they have in the factory.
And, what's this stuff?
Beeswax.
Beeswax? Good heavens, what do we do with that?
We'll sell it. Make the beautifulest candles you ever laid your eyes on. Mm-hmm. Things like stuff for, like the dentist makes for your false teeth.
Oh, you mean that goo that you bite down on when they take an impression?
Sure. And a million other things.
Boy, from the table to the dentist chair. Say, this is quite a business, isn't it, huh?
I told you you'd get a kick out of it.
I never dreamed it was like this. Well, let's go outside, huh?
Okay, come on.
Say, why are there so many blue flowers here in the garden?
Because the bee master says blue's a perfect color.
Oh, so it is.
Here, have a tomato.
Thank you.
And because the bees are the most perfect of any insect in the way they live, blue would be the color they love best.
Uh-huh. Say, listen, Scout, you seem to know everything that's going on around here. Maybe you can give me a line on a girl.
She's got soft, fluffy hair, blue eyes.
Hey, wait a minute. You aren't the kind of fella that likes the girls, are you?
Well, not exactly. Oh, no, no, of course not.
Well, then why do you ask such silly questions?
Go on, eat your tomato. This common sense are good for what ails you.
Yes, sir.
I gotta be getting home. Well, so long, pal. See you tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, gosh, I almost forgot. Look, the first chance you get when you go to see the bee master, will you buy him a hot dog for me?
A hot dog?
Sure. He's goofy about him. And tell him I send it with all my love and things.
All right, Shayla.
Well, bye.
Bye.
Don't forget to put the salt in the bee water in the morning.
I won't. Looks as though I'm going to have to delay this going to pieces for at least another night. Good for what ails you. Not bad. Neither is that.
I wouldn't do no fretting, Mrs. Cameron. Just because you didn't locate your daughter in the city doesn't mean she won't come back home.
I can't understand the girls nowadays. Maybe that's why Lucy ran away. Maybe it was mean. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Hicks, for the ride. It'll been a long walk from the bus line.
I'm glad to see you.
Goodbye.
Bye, Miss Cameron.
I wish I could understand it, but I don't. Why aren't there enough positions here in the city for school teachers without going way up north so far from home?
I don't know.
Is it my fault? Tell me. There isn't anything a mother wouldn't understand.
I don't know. I can't tell you. I can't explain it myself.
But don't you see,
oh, please,
Venus?
Please, let's not talk about it anymore tonight.
The deer!
Sardines and crackers. Well, come on. Mighty slim rations for a hungry man. Oh, what's the use of complaining? It'd be a lot worse. Come on, let's go outside and get ourselves some fresh air, huh? Come on. Say, looks like Mrs. Cameron's home. That's great. That means that tomorrow we start eating regularly. I hope she shows up early. Come on, boys. Just about now, the boys are heading for Tony's and the big feed. And then the press club. And here I am. 2,000 miles away, playing nursemaid to a flock of bees. Come on, we go for a walk. Come on. I'm seeing things. It isn't. It is.
Where? Why are you here?
Because your eyes are blue. And don't you know that the blue is the most perfect color in the whole world? Oh, no, you don't. I didn't detour 7 miles just in order to. Wait a minute. What's on your mind? What's so important that it can't be fixed?
Please, please go away.
Oh, lady, you might not know it, but you're talking to Jimmy McFarlane. The best little fixer-upper in the whole world. Why, he can fix anything. Anything. Anything, of course, but... You should see what those tears are doing to your eyes. That's better. Now, just settle back and tell me the whole thing.
All right. You asked for it. I'll tell you what I want. What's needed desperately. A marriage certificate and a wedding ring.
Marriage certificate and a wedding? Look, do you mind going back and starting in all over again? Wait a minute. You're really on the level, aren't you?
Stopped, aren't you, Mr. Fix-It?
No. No, I'm not stopped. Just slowed down a bit. Yeah, but I can fix that, too. If you don't mind being a widow in 6 months, maybe sooner.
A widow? I don't understand.
Don't you know who I am? I'm the wreck of the Hesperus. When you picked me up the other day, I was going to pieces. Yeah, Priscilla gave me the idea. She was a nurse at the government hospital where they finally convinced me that I'd wasted a lot of time trying to unguess a pair of bad lungs. So here I am. Slightly used, but at your service. What do you want me to do?
You mean that you'd actually marry me?
Why do you think that would be such an ordeal?
But I...
Well, haven't I just unloaded a lot of good reasons? What are we waiting for?
Will you promise, on your honor, that you'll marry me without even knowing who I am? And that you'll never try to find me again afterwards?
On my honor. If that's what you want.
And you'll meet me early in the morning, say, 9 o'clock at the marriage license bureau in the city.
Did you ever see such pretty blue eyes? A fine-looking bridegroom I'll make. Say, have I lost my mind completely? Well, I can always press the pants, and maybe the young fellow's got a white shirt and a nod coat. Have a look. Good morning. You're late for your wedding, Miss. Miss. Hold on.
Just a minute. I'd rather you let me pay all the expenses.
What kind of an egg do you think I am?
But you are broke. It cost $2 for the license and something for the judge. You only had $3.
This is as much my wedding as it is yours. And if I remember correctly, a fellow usually manages to pay for his own wedding. Well, I've managed. That watch never kept time anyhow. Come on.
Come, Patches.
I don't know, Emily. Maybe we better think this thing over.
Oh, Horace, after 10 years? It'll all be over in a minute.
That's what the dentist said.
We'd like an application, if you please. Thank you.
After you.
Well,
promised.
All right. But remember, young lady, when I stand up in the judge's chamber down the hall and marry you, this is going to look like the real thing. I don't get married every day in the week, and I want all the trimmings. When a fellow needs a friend.
Do you, James, take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Do you, Louise, take this man to be your lawful wedded husband?
I do.
Have you got the ring?
Yes.
All right, I'll get it out. It's a Woolworth special. I had to keep out $5 for his nips. I'm sorry. As a judge of the Supreme Court of Mandan County, by the law of the state, I pronounce you husband and wife.
Was that a Woolworth special, too?
No. That was a genuine McFarlane.
You've been very fine about the whole thing. And, well, I hope you're wrong about that 6 months. And there's a long and happy life in store for you. Honest, I do.
Thanks. But don't you worry about me.
Taxi.
Where shall I tell him?
Driver, I'll direct you later.
You should require any further services, Mrs. McFarlane. You can always reach me care of the Bee Master, Peaceful Bay.
The Bee Master?
Yes, you know, a fellow who raises bees. Hey! Never mind. General, are you? Well, let me salute you, sir.
Give us some soldier stuff.
Tell us about the war.
What battles have you been in?
Be our captain, will you?
Just a minute. Get back in ranks. Is it all right with you, General?
Sure. I mean, yes, sir. Go ahead.
All right, then. The first thing I want to talk about is this gun. As I came along, I saw you kids pushing and pulling. That's no way to handle a gun. Oh, when I was in the Army, we used to give it this. And this. And end up with this. Let that be warning to you kids about firearms. Who does this gun belong to?
Found it.
Well, I'll take it and keep it until the owner comes for it. Okay.
Attention! The last one to the rocks in the Pacific.
Margaret Cameron, and you're Jamie McFarlane, who gives bees water and crawls around on his stomach as if he were eating worms.
or playing duck. I know, but the little scout's been talking about me.
And about the Bee Master, too. There's one of the fine old characters that we need more of in this mad old world of ours.
Yeah. Yeah, he's a great old-timer.
I'm sorry I wasn't here. You see, I have to take care of him. He won't take care of himself. The man always doing for others as he is. But I've been having a little trouble of my own. What's the matter? Are you ill?
Hmm? Oh, no, nothing. I had to go to the city this morning, and I guess the sun kind of got me in walking back from the bus.
Never you mind that. We'll fix that. Here. You try this orange juice. It'll taste good.
Thanks.
The walk back from that bus line is awful. I guess if he marks a slip of a picture.
Oh, please, I can manage.
You drink that orange juice. Good gracious. Where'd you get a talk like that?
Well, it really wasn't like that when I got it. B-Master said I might borrow some of his.
I'll give you a pair after lunch. Amended 14 pairs before I went to town. You must be starved.
Yes, I am. Priscilla always said I was trying to eat my way out of the hospital.
Hospital? Are you in a hospital?
Uh-huh. Government.
Oh.
Yeah, they finally told me that I was licked. I had about 6 months or so to go, so I walked out of them. Took French leave. Just like that.
And right you were, those city doctors with a newfangled idea. They don't know what it's all about. You know, they told the Bee Master that same thing 30 years ago. 6 months. Fiddlesticks. Wait till you get some of this fine sea air into your lungs. Of course, that orange juice is better for you than all the pills and murderous concoctions they've been giving you. But boy, if you want to live, and you have faith in him and his power, that's the only anchor that will keep you here.
Are you serious?
Of course I'm serious. And I know what I'm talking about. You take the Bee Master's program, and in 6 months, you will be the liveliest looking cork you ever saw.
Maybe. Maybe that's what he thought, too, when he wished this goofy bee job on me. Gee, this chicken is swell. I feel better already.
Hospitals give me the creeps. Gee, I wish that lady would hurry. I haven't seen him for 2 whole months.
I bet he'd be tickled.
You may come in now.
Thanks.
Jamie, me, and the Cameron, and the bees, and the troopers, we all miss you like everything.
Yes. And I miss you, too. But it won't be long now, little partner.
You'll come home soon?
Yes, yes. Very soon.
Gosh, won't that be keen, Jamie? And where you get an eyeful, next to you, there isn't anyone in the whole wide world who can handle the garden and the bees, and even the black Germans. Like Jamie.
Yes, Jamie's good. He's been very, very kind. He makes me glad to come home.
Oh, gosh, I almost forgot.
Look, feast your eyes on that. A double-decker hot dog. The way you like them.
Nurse, that's my lunch. And don't you forget it.
I certainly will.
Jamie. Maybe we better go.
Yeah.
Getting kind of tired. We'll come back again soon, huh?
Yes. Yes, come tomorrow. Victory is just over the top, my friend. You'll see.
Yes. I'm beginning to feel it already.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, soldier.
Gee, I
wish it was tomorrow.
I can't do it. I can't accept it. I haven't earned it.
I'm sure the B-Master's will shows that he's a better judge of that than you.
Well, I can appreciate his leaving a share. For that matter, maybe all of his money as well as this place to Little Scout, but gosh, half to me. It isn't...
Jamie, you must accept it.
But Margaret, it isn't fair. It isn't right.
Look at me, Jamie. The B-Master never did anything that wasn't right. He was happy in the thought that he was entrusting the things he loved most into capable, honest hands. Don't you see? It was his service to them that helped to prolong his life. And he knew he'd do the same for you. And it's doing it.
James Lewis McFarland and Jean Marie Meredith. I knew that Little Scout was a girl all the time. She must have gotten a great kick out of thinking that she was fooling me.
Let's go swimming in the rock.
Sheriff.
What's the matter? Ain't you going in? You never want to go in the sun. Afraid to get your feet wet.
Attention. I'm general around here, and we're not going in swimming.
Okay, boys. Let's make up.
Oh, leave me alone. Jamie! Oh, Jamie!
To pieces because you wouldn't come clean and tell them why. Is that it, Jean Marie?
Who told you?
You don't suppose you could go on fooling me forever, do you?
Oh, I hate it, you know. Gee, they don't do anything.
Oh, is that so? Well, why do you suppose I'm around here raising bees instead of roaring around Chicago? Well, I suppose your idea of being something is a scoutmaster or a general. Is that it?
Mm-hmm. And climbing trees, and drilling, and playing baseball.
Oh, but listen, Funk, you don't have to run around with a pack of boys to do that. No, we'll find you a girls' camp where they're doing all the stunts that boys are doing.
A girls' camp?
Sure.
Oh, gee, that's swell. Oh, you're kidding.
No, honest. Cross my heart. And say, listen, with the head start that you got on them and all the stuff that you know, little wiseacre, why, you ought to be a scout mistress. Just like that.
Oh, that's keen. Something's happened, Jamie.
Yeah. Got some bad news for you. I want you to take it like a soldier.
A B-Master.
Yeah. Attention. Head up. Chin in. Eyes straight to the front.
He's dead.
Steady, soldier. We've got to carry on for him because he's left his bees and the bee garden to us. Hi there, Margaret. Sit down and take a load off your feet. Oh, so I even get tomato juice a la beach.
Yes, sir.
I drank so much of this stuff that my skin is turning red. You don't have to bring it down here.
Another hour of sun won't do you any harm. You missed it yesterday. That's the first time in months.
Yeah, but gee, can't a fella cheat just once and go to a ball game?
I hear the peaceful Bay Savages beat the socks off the troopers with Gene Mary rubbing it in at the end.
Well, of course. Well, they've never been the same since their general went petticoats and curls.
I can imagine. Say, you know, Jamie, I do believe you've taken on another pound right there.
Uh-huh. And, do you remember when I thought I only had 6 months to live?
Yes, it's a long time ago.
You know, honest, Margaret, I don't think I'd have ever stuck it out if the old bee master hadn't wished half that place up there on me. Because, well, something happened to me out there in those rocks when I first came. Something that...
I know. There's been something on your mind for a long time. I know, Jamie. If it'll make you feel any better, well, I'm listening.
I met a girl the first day that I was here. I never saw her before in all my life. I didn't know it then, but I fell in love with her. Oh, I know it'll all sound crazy to you, but... You see, I found out that she was in some sort of a spot. I didn't know what it was. Difficulty, some sort. She needed the protection of a man's name. So I gave her mine. I married her because I thought I only had 6 months to live. She said thanks, you know, just like that, thanks. Walked out. I never even knew who she was. All I know is that the fellow that let her down must have been an awful cad.
So you decided to get even and not to die after all.
Margaret, how do you think she's going to take a double cross like that? You know, she might want to get married again or something. I don't know. And, well, gosh, how am I going to go about finding her or doing something?
I don't know. I'm afraid I can't help you because I can't help myself.
Still no news about your daughter?
No. Jamie, why did she run away? If I only knew that Lucy was alive, it wouldn't be so bad. It would...
I know. Vibrations of that drum would drive all the bees to China instead of keeping them around the home hives.
Go on, Jamie. I'll take care of this stuff.
Okay, thanks, Margaret.
Peaceful Bay?
Yes.
Well, is Mr. James Lewis McFarlane there?
Yes, this is Mr. McFarlane's home.
May I speak to him, please? It's very urgent.
I'll call him. Jamie!
What do you want?
Telephone!
Well, find out who it is. I'm busy.
You better hurry up.
Oh, all right, then. I'll be up. Take this over to the tree, will you?
I don't know, but someone said it's very urgent. Hurry.
Oh, all right. Hello. Yes. What? Speak louder, will you, please? I can hardly hear.
The baby is doing nicely. It's a boy, 2 weeks old. But your wife is not reacting favorably. We are seriously alarmed, Mr. McFarlane.
Well, where is she?
What is it, James?
Shh, quiet. Yes. Yes, Dr. Hall's maternity home. Green Bay Road and Lexington. Yes, of course I'll be there. Certainly. Margaret, it's her. I found her. They talked as though they didn't expect her to pull through, so I've got to get there as quickly as I can.
426W.
Tell him I'll only be a minute.
Mr. Hicks, please. Oh, Mr. Hicks, this is Mrs. Cameron. Will you lend us your car? It's very important. You will? Thank you.
Yes, Doctor. He's here now. How is she?
She hasn't regained consciousness, but the doctor wants it. This way, please. Dr. Carter, Mr. McFarland.
Surely there must be some...
Please.
So you're Jim McFarland. I know we didn't hit it off together. And I should have told you he was coming. Please forgive me. Take the baby and give him a chance. I shan't mind going if I know you're giving him the protection he's entitled to.
Is she provided for?
Yes. A relative who made arrangement for her to come here. A cousin, Miss Molly Turner.
Oh.
Such a fine little chap, Mr. McFarland.
You have someone to help you with the child, Mr. McFarland?
Oh, yes, yes. An old friend of mine. My housekeeper.
Oh, Mr. McFarland, you've forgotten the baby's name. The baby?
Mr. McFarland has just taken him home.
Mr. McFarland?
You were out of the school with your class when we phoned. In this emergency, we had to find someone. We found the husband's address.
All right, Doctor. I'll make all the necessary arrangements later. Will you call a taxi for me, please? And ask them to hurry. I'll be downstairs.
Baby? What are you
going to
do with it?
I don't know. Where's Margaret?
She's gone to market. sure got your nose. Even when he's fussing.
Shh. What do we do with it?
Jimmy, you don't know how to hold a baby. No wonder he's fussing. Look at the way you handle it. You act as if you're scared stiff. Don't be so helpless. Pick him up a pair of pants.
Pants? Oh.
There's no guiding when you see him.
Then she's Margaret's.
Yes, dear. She died? Oh, my poor boy. And you loved her so much. The baby. Proud, Jamie. We can't take care of him over here.
Oh, no, I guess.
No, I'll take him over to my house where I can keep an eye on the little fellow. And you here, Jean. You run along down to the drugstore and tell Mr. Cook to give you 2 nursing bottles, 4 nickels, and a quart of the best olive oil he has.
Anything about taking care of babies. You're coming home with me.
Molly Turner. So she did it for her cousin.
The hospital notified you about Lucy by accident.
Little Manly forgotten your belongings.
I didn't intend for you to be troubled or to know. The baby. Did you give it to her to keep?
Yes, I did. And he's with his grandmother.
But you didn't tell Aunt Margaret that the baby was Lucy.
No. No, of course I didn't. I wouldn't break Margaret's heart for the world.
Lucy. My little baby. My little girl.
Don't you see? That's what I've been trying so desperately to keep from her. I didn't really mean to take advantage of your generosity that night down on the rocks. But I was desperate for Lucy's sake. I didn't know you belonged here. All of a sudden, you offered a solution. Don't you see? We couldn't hurt Aunt Margaret any more than you could a little while ago.
And I told her everything down there on the beach. Everything, of course, except the identity of the woman that I married.
And now Lucy's dead. What are we going to do? How can we ever explain it to Aunt Margaret?
Look, I have it. You don't know who I am. You've never seen me before. Tell her.
Aunt Margaret. something terrible has happened. I found Lucy. Oh, I don't know how to tell you.
You found her dying, didn't you?
Yes. Yes. In a hospital, after an automobile wreck. She died in my arms this morning. How did you know?
Oh, I just know. I knew when she stayed away so long, something would happen. And then, this morning, I woke with a start. Because I dreamed that she'd been fatally injured.
Oh, Margaret, I'm terribly sorry. I just heard as I came in through the door.
You're sweet, Jamie. Oh, I forgot. You two don't know each other, do you? Miss McFarlane, this is my niece, Molly Turner.
How do you do?
Why, Aunt Margaret, isn't that a baby?
Yes, of course it's a baby. It's Mr. McFarlane's baby.
Here I am. Well, I got everything. Hello, Molly.
Hello.
Where's our baby?
You come and see.
He sure is cute.
Mr. James Lewis McFarlane, Jr. Big name for such a little baby, isn't it?
I should say it is, but it's too much of a mouthful. Let's just call him Little Jamie.
All right. Here, you take the bottle and the nipples. Get a big pan of water and boil them while I rub him with oil.
Okay. I hope he grows up to be a prize fighter.
You know the penalty for forgery in this state? I fell in love with you that night on the rocks. And I still am. You don't suppose you could manage to be out there again soon, do you?
It might be arranged.
No matter what comes to us, we must still have faith. We must always have faith.